Hi everyone. If we were in school this week, we would be doing our sensory circuit. So being that we're at home, I thought we would have a go at doing a home-based sensory circuit. Sensory circuits are great. They give us a really good opportunity to kind of warm up our bodies, build our body awareness, give us a good burst of sensory input. They can give us an opportunity to develop skills, and overall they just give us a way of feeling more balanced and prepared for whatever the day might have in store. Sensory circuits are broken down into three parts. So the first part is the alerting section. So if you think of, if you go to the gym, that's all about kind of the warm-up part, so waking our bodies up, warming up our muscles and joints, and just getting that sensory feedback for us and to understand what our body's doing and where it's doing it. The second part is the organising part. So if you think of that being maybe your overall workout or an exercise class, so this is where you're doing more coordinated movements, more planned and controlled movements, and a lot more sequencing in what you do. So it takes a lot more focus and attention, and it's more of a challenge. And then the last part is the calming section. So if you think of that in terms of a cool down, it's all about getting some relaxation and just kind of winding down after the sensory input that you've had in the previous sections. So yeah, we'll have a go. I have gathered together an array of things from around my house. Hopefully you'll be able to utilise similar objects. I've tried to kind of do a range of activities for each section with a range of things, so hopefully there will be something for everybody to have a go at. So yeah, let's have a try. I hope that's given you some ideas. You can do a sensory circuit inside, you can do it in your garden, you can do it across a few rooms, you could do part one in one room and balance your way through to part two, however you want to do it. And if all else fails and it doesn't really turn out like a sensory circuit, at least while we're staying home, it'll be some much needed movement and sensory input. So stay safe. Hopefully we'll all be back in school soon and back to our